Intel's new 10th gen processors are shaping up to be an impressive update to their lineup, and they deserve motherboards just as impressive. Luckily, Gigabyte is releasing a comprehensive lineup of new motherboards that exceed expectations and look to scratch almost any itch a performance-minded tech fan like yourself could want. In this video, we'll be going over the new Gigabyte Vision G, Pro AX, Aorus Ultra, and Aorus Master motherboards. So, let's strap in. First off, the Aorus Master lives up to its name, with incredible construction quality from a heavy-duty 14-phase digital VRM with 90-amp power stages, rocking polymer capacitors that increase the stability and performance of overclocking to improved M.2 thermal designs for cooler operation. Every component on board is built to last with overclocking in mind, so your system will stay blindingly fast. The VRM is cooled by a next-generation nanocarbon fins array 2 and direct touch heat pipes 2 with a nanocarbon CPU baseplate for extreme heat management under even the most demanding load. Wi-Fi 6 and 2.5 gigabit networking keep you connected with the latest specs, and if you're lucky enough to have the capabilities, an incredible data throughput. Fiber internet? Ha! The Aorus Master handles it without breaking a sweat. Add to all of that high bitrate audio with an onboard ESS Saber DAC and USB-C 3.2 Gen 2, and you can output full 4K or run a VR headset with incredibly lifelike fidelity. The Aorus Master is definitely a board for the dedicated enthusiast. But what if you aren't quite as demanding on your hardware, with slightly less exacting overclocking and heat expectations, but you still want a platform that will stand the test of time while being stable as a rock? The Aorus Ultra has many of the things that make the Master so incredible, like polymer capacitors in its VRM, but delivers it with a more modest 12-phase 50-amp array. Modest here is a relative term, because this board can still deliver some seriously beastly power to your new 10th gen Intel CPU. Nanocarbon fins and a beefy Direct Touch 2 heat pipe setup, just like the Master, ensures the best cooling for the board's most important components, but lacks the nanocarbon baseplate of its bigger brother. The Ultra has the same set of PCIe inputs, with a single PCIe 3x16 slot, PCIe 3x8 slot, and one PCIe 3x4 slot. Each board can take four DDR4 dual-channel RAM modules with a shielded memory routing design, meaning there's less electrical interference that could mess with any memory overclocking you're doing. Speaking of memory overclocking, all of Gigabyte Z490 boards have expansive memory support and are pushing the limits of higher XMP profiles. That means easy memory speed changes, excellent compatibility, and rock-solid stability, even when you're running your rig hard. Networking is handled by the same Intel Wi-Fi 6 and 2.5 gigabit chipset as the Master, so you won't be lagging behind anyone. The Gigabyte Pro AX takes a step down in price, but delivers the serious goods with the same heavy-duty 12-phase 50-amp digital VRM of the Ultra, only lacking the fancy nanocarbon coating. The board employs the networking chipset from all of Gigabyte Z490 boards, and similar inputs as the other two, so this board would be great for building an SLI or Crossfire rig that can handle some decent overclocking. And finally, we have the Vision G, which is priced the lowest of the bunch, but delivers on aesthetics, power, and functionality in a big way. While the other three boards have a beautiful black, straight-edged design sensibility that gives them a sleek John Wick vibe, the Vision G is all stainless steel and vaporwave, with subtle colored stripes on the edges of some of the components. It's a seriously beautiful board that would look great in your case, lit up by plenty of RGB, of course, thanks to the onboard RGB controller. It's rocking the same VRM as the Ultra and Pro AX, and is well stocked with inputs for all of your gear, two M.2 slots, and any dual graphics card needs. It has the same onboard 2.5 gigabit networking, but doesn't have onboard Wi-Fi like the other three boards. Gigabyte's new Z490 boards for the upcoming Intel 10th generation chips are seriously impressive additions to their lineup, and give gamers more options than you can shake a stick of RAM at. With their mix of robust features and generous performance for the price, we can't wait to get our hands on them for potential builds in the future. What would you build with these boards once they hit Newegg? Let us know in the comments, and thanks so much for watching.